Listen. You won't like it a more beautiful sound than that. Yeah.
Think I need that drink. T-bone steak time. We cured for 21 days, pre-packed. Very famous. If you live in Ireland, Northern Ireland, champ. It's very, very popular in our country. Don't know if you can get it anywhere else, but I absolutely love that stuff. I'd eat that on its own. We tipping you buy one of these? Before you light it, take the plastic off. And always expose of your rubbish, never leave it lying about. The thing that really pisses me off, and I've been here quite a few times before, people leave their beer bottle tops and their beer tops in fires for people like Michael and any of the volunteers to come along and have to pick up the, you know what I mean? So, matter of 2 seconds, put it in the bin, put it in your pocket, take it away with you. That's the way it should be done. Wee tip. If you want a nice steak, never, never wash the frying pan. Leave it outside, let insects, things light on it, and then heat it up again. Throw the steak on. Absolutely delicious.
Never allow them to land on my food. They'll vomit, they'll poop, they'll spread contagious diseases, and you will die.
Another wee tip. Sprinkle it in. When you're cooking it, it marinates into the meat. Never done this before. Normally don't have the patience to do it. But looks pretty straightforward enough. Can't go wrong, really. Or can we go wrong? Ooh. Okay. That was easy. Alright. Okay. Well, sort of looks like a seat. When the steak's cooking, take a while to do that steak.
Oh,
get on. Yeah, looks pretty good. Oh. So, if the steak cooking, sitting on the chair relaxing, only one on this island, except the chickens. So if I get lonely later on, I'll probably have a wee chat with some of them. If I get hungry tomorrow. Anyway, back to the steak. That's called steak in a frying pan with chomp. Actually looks quite nice. Cheers. Let's see what the island has to give. Let's go this way. The monastery's up here. Here's a monastery. That's Michael, but apparently there was skeletons found somewhere in around the bottom there a few years back. That dates back over 1,000 years. And this down here was the camp. Wow. That looks pretty amazing. Usually when we camp up here we would get the motorbike, the trike, whatever you want to call it. To take all the luggage up in the back of the bike, because there's no way you can walk on hill with tents, etc. And fair play to Michael and the volunteers, they do a fantastic job. You know, there's a lot of work involved keeping up and trying to keep an island, trying to get it sorted for the public, you know, and trying to keep the pathways clear, and especially in the winter time. So the camp that we used to camp in is over here. Yeah, there it is. Wow. I've been here for 2 years. The last time we were here was the heavy rain. I think I'm one of the first people to come back on the island since the COVID regulations as well. Everything's so overgrown. That they're not beautiful. Wow. So in around this area would be where we would put all our tents. And then that would be obviously that would be the fire. And the last time we stayed here, our tent was there. We had a river running through it as well. Feeling quite emotional actually. Realize how much you miss a place until you actually come back and see it. Had a wonderful weekend. Never change it for anything. Full of emotions. Just hits you out of nowhere. And it's so peaceful up here. This is one of her favorite places to come with friends, me and Connor. She loved this place. So many emotions coming back to this island. I just was here so many times with Carl and the friends. Just to come back on the island. It's bizarre, it's strange, it's weird. Just feeling all these strange emotions that just hit me when I came up here. so different. You'd hear so many people talking and laughing, carrying on,
firelit,
so many tents. Good memories. Beautiful memories. I mean, look at this place. So anybody wants to come here, just check out Ram's Island. So I'll post that description down below as well.
I'm a goner, can't even get away from it. Wonder, can he pull a wheelie in that thing?
Hi everybody at home. My name is Michael. I'm one of the volunteers on Ram's Island.
Yeah.
And as you can see, this is one of the jobs I do, is cutting the grass and keeping the paths clear and killing weeds and looking after the wildlife.
Right.
Stuff like that.
Michael, you haven't a clue who I am, have you?
Gary's your first name, that's all I know.
I'm actually quite famous.
Is that right?
Yeah. The reason why I came here this weekend was to celebrate my 1 million subscriber on my YouTube channel.
Oh, that's very good.
Yeah, so pretty proud of that. Anyway, so I won't keep you back from your work.
All right, no problem. Did you sleep okay last night?
I did. I slept well, apart from that chicken out the back. It's going to get shot later on.
What time did he start up at?
4 o'clock.
Oh, dear. Daylight, yeah.
Shotgun? Right. And that's your wee boat out there as well, isn't it?
Right.
Nice. What's the name of your boat?
San Cristobal.
It's not the Titanic, is it? No.
No. She's a green. I don't think.
And your name's not Captain Smith?
No.
All right. I'll see you later on.
All right.
All right. Cheers. Looks like Captain Smith. So what do you do here on the island? Volunteers?
I just look after the place and take care of a cup of grass.
Do you feed the chickens too?
I feed the chickens. Right. And then when it's open we bring people over and back. And then they go up and what you're doing.
Are you related to Captain Smith?
No, he lives in like my street, so I know him. I've known him for 3 years. I've come over here for a long while.
Right. Okay, what about you? How long have you been doing this, sir?
Well, not that long, like.
Right. You never smile, though? So you got a license to ride that?
Why?
What happened to the drone?
Think that's funny?
Yeah.
I actually lost it in the water.
Did you get it?
Yeah, he's actually laughing now, you see. Laughing at somebody's misfortune. Yeah, no, I did get it actually, but it was 4 feet from the water's edge and it was floating in underneath. The ironic thing was, I put another battery in it, it worked for about 5 seconds and then went pop, gone. That's what I'm saying for you. And you keep smiling. Let's see what chicken I'm going to have for lunch here.
Any of them,
right. It'll have to be the biggest one. He thinks I'm joking, I'm actually serious. He's got a flat tire. Hard to believe it's dead in a haunted island all night. This cottage, for me, is... It's small, but it's compact. It has its all mode cons. You have your thermal solar panel heating. You have your kettle, your toaster, your fridge, freezer. You even have a TV. You even have Wi-Fi as well. What else would you ask for, really? And yeah, it's quaint. I'm going to bring my girls back later this year as well. So this vlog for me was a mixture of everything, really. From worrying about the weather, worrying about coming across in the boat, worrying about how it's going to do the vlog. But all my vlogs are never pre-planned or anything like that. I just get on the bike and just go with the flow. Sometimes that's the best way to do it. I mean, when I arrived here, Michael, gentleman as always, and one of the volunteers was fantastic. Really helped me a lot, brought the stuff off the boat for me. showed me everything about the cabin. And for 40 acres of land, it sits in the middle of Loch Ness. It's beautiful. And for to say that I stayed on an island on my own, that's pretty cool as well. Would I do it again? Of course I would. But if this is the first time you're watching, if you'd like to subscribe, you know what to do. Come bring your motorbike across. But it's sitting only half a mile away. I couldn't bring Harley Davidson across in the boat, but it would be something to bring your bike onto this island. You've got the paths. That would be pretty cool, actually. Take a Harley Davidson up to the top camp. Wow. Maybe one day. But for now, just gonna enjoy Mother Nature. Cue the birds. Okay, don't cue the birds. So this island's supposed to be haunted by the Banshee.